Adela Nsanzeruvugo, who used to have two fishing boats, narrates that their fishing gear were destroyed, yet they couldn't afford the required 28-foot boats. Our small boats were destroyed by the Fish Protection Unit officers, yet we can't afford hiring engines to operate 28-foot boats, which are required. We could only afford hand-manned boats with some simple nets, as it used to be in the past. Men no longer care about children, and this is a huge burden to us women. Ever since the destruction of our boats, we no longer have a stable source of income. They want us to go as far as possible, but we can't manage due to the strong waves. Restrictions on fishing silverfish near the shoreline were based on allegations that they catch immature Nile perch and thus considered to be illegal fishing. Joseph Mukasa says the government has the capacity to ban selling of illegal nets that are used by fishermen, and it would be the best solution rather than banning and arresting innocent fishermen. We appeal to the leaders and government to fight traders of illegal fishing gear rather than arresting people. Yet there is no orientation done in prisons on proper fishing methods.
Government erina capacity esobola okukola ki okukirwanyisa.
Some women who have invested in fishing have appealed to the government to ease restrictions. We appeal to the government to help us and avail an income-generating activity so that we can educate our children as well as look after them. Our base has been agriculture, but we are banned from accessing gardens, and soon we are becoming helpless. Government should at least release some restrictions so that illegal fishing operations officers leave us women to engage in silverfish fishing using affordable boats. Story by Samuel Nkuba for the news.